Here are five things you need to know about the new COVID vaccine. The new COVID vaccine is for everyone 6 months and older.
The new vaccines are really targeting the latest variants of Omicron. And so, the aim of these vaccines are to prevent hospitalization, try to keep you out of the hospital, and to decrease death associated with COVID. And after looking at all of the data, the group that advises the CDC decided that it would be equitable and really simple to try to go ahead and recommend these to everyone ages 6 months and above. And I think that pairs really well with the recommendation for the flu shot, which is also for everyone 6 months and older.
The CDC says recent COVID-positive patients may wait to get the latest vaccine.
There's been, I think, a lot of people waiting for this. And unfortunately, some of those people have gotten COVID recently. So I think it's really individualized. First of all, if you have had COVID infection recently, you can probably wait about 3 months before you need to get that booster. So if you just, you know, unfortunately got it last week, you can, I usually put something in my calendar to remind me, hey, it's been 90 days, you know, it's probably time now. That's the first group. I would really recommend people over the age of 65. If you have a loved one, you know, who is in a nursing home or a long-term care facility, those folks really do need to get boosted this season. And then, you know, going back and thinking about everyone in your family, this recommendation is coming out for almost everyone. And as we have kids going back to school, you know, these are really things that can help them stay in school and stay healthy.
Vaccine immunity can build in 2 weeks.
If you haven't been sick in the last 3 months, now is a great time to go ahead and get them because it takes about 2 weeks for your immunity to build up. But once it's there, it does last a while. So I think that would probably be my advice rather than waiting it out now that they're available. Again, it also depends on whether you're traveling a lot coming up, you know, if you're going to be meeting family for Christmas and Thanksgiving. Even getting it now, it should help you boost your immunity for those events.
Doctors say it's safe to get the RSV, flu, and COVID vaccines together.
I would recommend at this time that it is completely safe. There's actually been work done on this, that it's safe to get the flu and the COVID vaccine at the same time. You know, you might be sore in that arm. You are going to be sore regardless. And, you know, you need them around the same time. So I would go ahead and get those two at the same time. Probably makes sense to wait a week or two to get the RSV vaccine. And again, that RSV vaccine is going to be available for people older than 60, pregnant people, and then for children as well, for babies.
Health officials urge people to get this updated COVID vaccine.
When you look at the amount of people that actually got the booster last year, it was a very low amount. So about 17% of the U.S. population got a booster. That's a very small amount. So that really affects kind of how you think about the effectiveness, right? And again, I think for the group of people that did get it, and again, thinking about people who are really at risk for severe hospitalization, that's people older than 60 or 65, only half of those folks got boosters as well. So I think that part of, as we think about how effective these are, is to think about how many people are really getting the vaccine. And our hope is that with this push into the winter, we have a number of tools kind of in our arsenal now. If you have insurance through work, you're going to get the shot just the way that you did before. It should be covered at your local pharmacy. If you don't have insurance, for children, there are programs in place to try and get all children the vaccines that they need. And then also for adults, that is going to likely be through your public health department. If you go to vaccines.gov, there is hopefully an easy to use infographic there that can help you find where to go based on your zip code.